Hey everybody. Some of you know that I like trains. I've been asked before, why do I like trains? Well, I'm not sure. Why do any of us like anything? When it comes to trains, for me, I guess, it all started when I was just a boy. My town was serviced by a railroad named the Milwaukee Road. And I used to love to see the black and orange locomotives as they sat in the engine yard each time our family car passed by that particular crossing. Among the many buildings in the engine yard was a small roundhouse. And many times the doors of the stalls would be open and you could see locomotives sitting in the roundhouse. And I'm not sure why that fascinated me as a young child, but it did. When I got old enough to ride a bicycle, my friends and I would ride a few blocks away to where trains went over a particular street. Now, back then, the rail cars that carried new automobiles, they weren't covered in sheet metal the way the rail cars are today. So you could see what kind of automobile was on the rail car. And I remember watching long trains of brand new Chevrolet Caprices roll by on their way to the dealerships. The friends that went with me most of the time, well, they like trains too. I'm not sure where they got their fondness for trains. One kid, his dad worked for a place that made caskets or coffins. And his dad brought home a model, a scale model of the factory that he worked at that made the caskets. So he had a train set on this piece of wood. In the center of it was this casket company. And he had a Tyco HO scale train. It's a little Santa Fe switcher. It was just a simple oval, but I thought it was the neatest thing. I remember another friend of mine had the Tyco Spirit of 76 train set. It had the Elco 430 diesel engine. I remember the line L train set my friend down the street got for Christmas one year, in the hours that we spent playing with it. And I remember the Tyco HO scale train set that I got for Christmas the following year. My dad and I set it up on a 4x8 sheet of plywood and sat it atop some sawhorses so that it was waist high to me. So that was my first model railroad. And once you have a model railroad, you have to add accessories and stuff to it. Now those accessories and things were bought at the hobby shop. And in my town, back then, the hobby shop was Brown's hobby shop, I believe. And it was a lot of fun to go to the hobby shop, but it was kind of sad at the same time, because it was fun because I enjoyed looking at all the model train stuff. But it was sad because most of the time I had to leave without being able to purchase anything. Sure, when money allowed, I got some extra rail cars and some few pieces of new track now and then. Trains. Well, they're just fun to watch. Real trains, model trains, toy trains, it doesn't matter. It's been said by different people that things that move are more interesting than things that don't. And I tend to agree with that quite a bit. The power of a train. I know the diesel locomotives, at least back when I was a kid, typically had 700 plus cubic inches, and that was per cylinder. And the diesel engines and the locomotives had 16, sometimes 20 cylinders. A young boy that can walk up and touch the lead engine of an idling freight train probably never forgets it his entire life. At least I haven't. When you're standing next to a string of GP7s or F9s that are idling, the ground just seems to vibrate beneath your feet. And what about the kid who grew up in the 40s or 50s in the New York City area? Think of all the subways, trolleys, commuter and inner city trains that he got to ride just to get around. What a world of wonder for a kid who could just look out his bedroom window and see train after train. Some of you may have had a train set around the Christmas tree, or maybe you had a permanent layout in your house. But to see real trains outside your window as a kid must have been much better. Trains represent the larger world being connected. And railroads put on a show, a a ballet, if you will, of enterprise, industry, energy, and ingenuity. And they perform this ballet not only in large cities, but in small towns across the country. Yes, trains are tons and tons of metal in motion. They're big, powerful, loud. As a kid, I mean, what's not to like? If you were lucky as a kid, there was a shady spot overlooking a main line that had a slight incline. Sitting in the shade, watching locomotives battle the hill was a great way to pass a Saturday morning with friends, especially if you had a bag of potato chips and some bottles of pop. Now, in between trains, we weren't constantly discussing trains. I mean, we talked about other things as we waited for the next train to come along. And we talked about the football, especially the Green Bay Packers, or the Milwaukee Bucks basketball team, or the Brewers baseball. And as we got older, we even talked about girls and everything else you can imagine. Yes, those were fun outings. Those eventually turned into outings that were taken not by bicycle, but by car, as we got old enough to obtain driver's licenses. A good freight yard always provided plenty of interest, especially if it was a hump yard, where the engines pushed freight cars to the crest of a small hill and then uncoupled them so that they could roll on their own into one of the tracks below that was chosen by somebody working in the yard tower. So the people have, there's plenty of people with interest in trains. And maybe their interest came from, I don't know, maybe the old bridge watchman, or I'm not sure what you call it, bridge watchman. And maybe he could tell railroad stories for as long as you could stay. Or maybe your interest in trains came from standing on a station platform as a glimmering passenger train pulled in and dropped off and picked up passengers before pulling out again. I know I spent quite a few hours hanging around the small passenger station in my town when I was a kid. Maybe you were lucky enough to take a long train ride across the country and remember the experience. The meals in the dining cars, the views from the windows, or the way the train could rock you to sleep at night. I was once enjoying a meal in the dining car of a train out of New Orleans. And at some point into my meal, I heard a voice from my childhood. Then I looked over and saw an uncle that I hadn't seen in maybe 20 years or so. And he was sitting across the aisle from me on that train in the middle of Mississippi somewhere. Now, he's long since passed away. But I'll never forget his surprise to see me on that train. Well, perhaps you've laid awake at night listening to locomotives that were miles away as they struggled trying to get up a grade, an incline. Or maybe you could hear the slack being taken out of a train that was miles away as the freight cars protested heavily to the pull of the locomotives as they began their journey. It's funny how far sound can travel on a still night. Yes, freight trains are big, noisy, and they're looming as they get closer and closer. They actually make the ground heave. Cars, trucks, bicycles, taxis, nothing else comes close to seeing a train pass by mere feet from you. And for some people, trains only appear in certain situations. You can look up and see an aircraft, but you can look outward from a window or down a block, across a parking lot, down a street, and not see any hint of a train or its infrastructure. You see, when it comes to trains, you usually have to just come upon it or live next to it. The more you think about trains, the more incredible, complex, yet simple, expensive, magnificent, useful, and economical they seem. Maybe you have stood close to a train track and wondered how something that looks so fragile can handle the weight and power of a train as you sight down a long stretch of mainline rail, noticing how that flat line of steel is so perfectly parallel with the other. Then you're amazed at how well the track is kept in place. Maybe you like the pending calm around a right-of-way, and then are thrilled when suddenly the silence is broken, and it's like thunder as a big train passes near you at high speed. And then once it's gone, the silence sets in again. And what about steam locomotives? Those things are like fire-breathing dragons. And if you're lucky enough to have seen one in action, you'll never forget it, especially if it steamed you as it went by. I've ridden on a few trains that were pulled by steam locomotives. And perhaps I'll upload some footage of those trips, if anyone's interested. And I guess the crowning achievement for any school-age boy that likes trains is to be invited into the cab by the crew of the local yard switcher, because they've seen you in that same spot along the track with your school books every afternoon for a month, just watching them maneuver the big engine around the yard. I'm not sure how much that occurs today. It's very easy for anyone working for the railroad to lose their job if they break even the slightest of rules. But back in the day, being invited up into the cab wasn't that uncommon. Yes, I like trains, and I've come to realize that to those who understand, no explanation is necessary. And to those that don't, no explanation will suffice. I hope you found that this video was relaxing. If you want to see more trains, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching.